working on ancient DNA is very exciting because, you know, we're using really the cutting edge of science to learn about history. One of the interesting questions about the development of agriculture in Europe is to what extent it was cultural transmission as opposed to a movement of people.
And we know through work that we and others have done in the last couple of years that people in Europe today are largely a mixture of three ancestral populations.
We know that agriculture was first developed in the Near East, Anatolia, and then it moves into Europe maybe 8,000 years ago and then spreads throughout the whole of Europe. It's very clear from the archaeology that around that time people in Europe changed from a hunter-gathering lifestyle to an agricultural lifestyle. But one thing you can't tell from the archaeology is whether this is actually a movement of people, you know, people moving from Anatolia into Europe, or whether this is cultural transmission. And we've had kind of hints before, but one thing this study makes very clear with samples from Anatolia is that actually this is a movement of people.
I think the things that we're most interested in is the adaptation of complex traits. The most exciting one is height.
For example, Northern Europeans are taller than Southern Europeans, and that has a genetic cause. And actually, you can tell by looking at modern day people that that's due to selection. But what you can't tell from looking at modern day people is when that happened. And with this study, we're able to really narrow that down to, you know, within a few thousand years of when those changes in height are actually happening.
So during this time period, people adapted to the new needs of these environments. And so we are watching in action natural selection as these adaptations occur.